At this point, you should have audio and your main footage on the timeline. If your audio is separate from your video recordings, you should edit it first to remove any mistakes and have it ready to start matching video footage. If your audio is good to go, you may want to lock your audio track so you don't accidentally remove or change it. Let's begin the first steps of editing your content. If you haven't already, make sure your clips are in the correct sequence order. Next, starting at the beginning of your timeline, go through and start looking for mistakes to remove from your video. You should listen to the audio and make sure your audio and video are starting to match as you go. In addition to removing mistakes, you'll want to remove any other parts that you don't want to show to your viewer. This could include typing, any pop-ups, or anything that appeared on the screen accidentally. As you find a mistake, go ahead and remove it. Most video editors will provide several methods for removing parts of video clips. I'm using Camtasia for our demonstration, but other video editors will use similar approaches, but the terminology may be different. Most digital video editing tools are non-destructive, meaning that if you cut or delete portions of a video on your timeline, you've only changed your timeline and you haven't changed your original file, and you can restore anything that you've removed. So if you make a mistake, don't worry, it's easy to fix. Learning the different ways to remove content is an important aspect of video editing and one of the most important changes you can make to any video. The first way is the split tool. When you use the split tool, you'll move your playhead or the vertical line showing the current playback position to the point you'd like to separate. In the case of removing mistakes, you'll move it to a point on the timeline before the mistake. Then use the split button or the keyboard shortcut. To remove the clip though, you'll need to add another split after the mistake. To remove the mistake, select the clip, usually by clicking on it, and then hitting the delete key. If the mistake happens towards the beginning or the end of a video clip, the software will treat the start or end of the clip as a split, which allows you to easily delete the mistake. Another way to remove content is to use a cut instead of a split. The idea of a cut is that you highlight or select the section of the clip that you want to remove. Then you either hit the cut button or the delete key. This will remove anything that is highlighted. With both splitting and cutting, you may find that as you edit and remove unwanted parts, you end up creating blank gaps between clips. You'll either need to move the clips around to line them up again, or some programs will have the option to ripple delete or ripple edit. For instance, in Camtasia, if I select the section I want to remove, then right click on it and select ripple delete, everything right of the remove section slides to the left. Regardless of how you remove the gaps, most of the time you won't want them in your video, unless you plan to fill the gaps with other content during that time. It's worth noting that there is a slight difference between cut and delete. Cut will remove the clip and add it to your clipboard, which you can then paste that section elsewhere on your timeline. Delete will just remove the content. It's a small difference, but helpful to know. The last way we'll look at removing footage in this lesson is the use of trimming. Trimming applies to the beginning or end of a clip. To trim, move your cursor over the edge of a clip. Typically, the cursor will change shape when you're in the correct spot. Then you can click and drag the edge of the clip to shorten it, and it has the same effect as cutting the clip. As you're editing, if you found that you took a little too much off of a clip and you want to add it back into the editor, you can select the clip and move your cursor to its edge, but instead of clicking and dragging to make the clip shorter, drag the edge to make it longer, restoring the cut portion back to the timeline. Next, we'll look at how to control the pace of your video, making sure that your audio and video are in sync and start to look good.